Good week, good day to all of you.
I'm back with another 20, maybe 25 minute full body yoga fusion flow for you. This is an awesome flow to start your day with. It's an awesome flow to warm up with for any other movement practice that you have, if it's yoga, functional training, martial arts. You can name it. We address the whole body, strengthening, lengthening a little bit. Join me and enjoy. I'm going to start in a kneeling position. Both hands on the lap, fingers facing one another, elbows face out. As you inhale, bring the elbows back, bring the chest forward, the heart forward, the gaze up. And on an exhale, pubic bone to belly button, tailbone under, press the hands in the lap and collapse the chest and the chin towards one another. Inhale, a little arch. Exhale, round, pulling pubic bone and belly button towards one another. Again, inhale, come forward, shoulders draw back. Exhale, belly draws back, tailbone goes under, chin to the chest. One more like this. Next, inhale, come up onto your knees. Bring your hands to the lower back. Exhale, step your right foot forward. Keeping the hands supporting the lower back, inhale, come forward, sink into your left thigh. Right heel stays on the floor. Exhale, bring your right toes up. You can try to bend, to extend the right knee. Inhale, come forward, look for full range of motion. Right heel stays down, but knee can pass the heel. And on the exhale, you might sit all the way onto your left. Inhale, pull the shoulders back, arch the chest up. Exhale, lengthen through the spine and bring your nose in the direction of your big toe. Let's do that again. Of course, you work with your range of motion. Next time you're back, stay back. All right. I'm going to sprinkle the fingers back. See if we can repeat this movement without our hands. So the arms come down and forward and up as you inhale. Then the arms go down and back as you exhale. So all the time through the floor. Inhale, down, forward and up. Exhale, down and back. Again, inhale. This is the last one. Exhale, gliding back. Now step into the right foot. Bring your left hand on the inside of the right leg. Tuck your left toes under and inhale your left knee off the floor and your right arm up. Now you want to press into the left hand. Get both of your arms perpendicular to the floor. Reach your left heel away from the crown of the head and gaze up or down. Doesn't matter if you're gazing up or down. Make a baby fist of your right hand and circle through the wrist. Three times in each direction. From here, come to still. The left hand is going to move to the left corner of the mat. You're going to come to the outside of the left foot so you can sweep or step your right foot behind the left knee. Now first bring your hips up, both feet as much as you can grounded, and then bring them back down with your hands in front of your chest. If you need to replace the feet, so you can come flat on the right foot and on the outside of the left leg as you lift up. Slowly coming back down. Again. Strong in the legs so you can really open the hip, outer rotate the right knee out. Slowly come down, sit down, flex your left toes up, cross your right leg over the left, support yourself with the right hand and lengthen through the spine as you bring left elbow and right knee together. Next, inhale, find length, twist from the center of your heart over to the right side as you exhale. Two more. Now let's untwist on the in-breath. Replace right foot on the inside of the left leg. Replace left hand on the front of the mat. And we're going to come up into that wild thing again. Now see if you can engage the left side of the body. Pick up the right foot and place it in the direction of your left hand. If you want, you can help with your hand. We're going to end up where we just came from in a runner's lunge. Take a deep breath in. And on an exhale, step to downward facing dog.
Your feet about hip distance apart, your hands about shoulder distance apart. Spread the feet wide, spread the toes wide, and move a little bit. This can be by bending one knee after the other, relaxing the head or hinging a few times in the shoulder. Mind that your pubic bone, belly button want to magnetize towards one another. Your sit bones want to lift, your tailbone wants to curl, and your collarbones want to be white. Come to stillness, and then inhale, lift the heels off the floor. If you can see yourself on a screen, mind that your back stays long, having a look at my back. Now on the next inhale, the heels stay up or come back up, depending if you went down on the exhalation. Moving up with the heels on the in-breath, and down on the out-breath. I'm gonna change some things. Both heels go up, inhale. Ripple forward into plank. Stay with your shoulders over your wrist, your back a little rounded, so you can gently lower the right knee, but extend it again as you exhale. Gently lower the left knee. Extend it again as you exhale. Let's lower both knees.
Tuck our toes.
Bring the weight back up, hands onto the hips, and even a little onto the lower back. Bring your left foot forward, inhale, hinge forward. Exhale, glide back, butt back, flex the left toes. Now watch my right toes. Inhale, I come forward. Exhale, I draw back. So I have the opportunity to bring a little bit of stretch in the toes. If you prefer to keep the feet flat, that's fine. Know what your options are.
Now that you know that your hips
are facing forward, just bring your arms up and then sprinkle them through the floor back down. Coming forward and up
and gliding down and back. Once again. Stepping into the left foot.
Both hands next to the left foot, extend the right leg. And then circle your left arm over the head. Twist. Stay low in the hips so your hip is as low as your knee. Pressing the whole left foot down, arms perpendicular to the floor. Meaning that there's one straight line between the finger pads through the collarbones into the other hand. Gaze up or down, make a baby fist with your left hand and start rotating. Right hand to the right corner of the mat, come on the outside of the right foot. You're going to sweep or step left foot behind the right leg and lift the hips. Lift the heart, gaze at the left hand if you can. Press more weight in the outer edges of the feet, the knife edges. Take an in-breath. Slowly sit down as you exhale. We're going to go back up. You can replace your left foot. Inhale, come up. Exhale, coming down. Again, inhale, coming up.
Exhale, coming down.
Stay seated. Flex your right toes up. Cross your left leg over the right. Hug your left leg with the right arm. Support yourself with the left arm. Inhale, lengthen the spine. And from the center of the heart, twist as you exhale. Inhale, finding, gathering. Exhale, twisting.
One more breath.
Untwist on an inhalation. Replace your left foot on the inside of the right leg. Right hand comes forward and we're going to lift up in this thing that's called wild thing. Now from here, take a deep breath in. Make your way back onto hands and feet with your hands under your shoulders and your feet under the hips. Toes are under.
Take a deep breath in.
You may lower the knees, otherwise chest goes down to the floor, coming back up. So with the knees down or the legs lifted, twice more, slowly coming up. One more coming down, slowly coming up. Bring your butt up, and then walk yourself into downward facing dog. Relax your head, sway a little from side to side, find a little bit more space. Breathe in and out through the nose, relax your jaw. Anchoring your gaze.
Coming to stillness when you're ready.
Inhale, lift your heels, belly button in. Exhale, lower them down. Inhale, lift the heels. Exhale, lower them down. One more. Inhale, lift the heels. And then slowly lower down. Next time you lift the heels, you ripple forward into high plank. Now keep your arms straight. Lower your hips down to the floor.
Untuck your toes, bend the elbows, take an in-breath here. And exhale, come onto the belly. Place your fingers as wide as your mat, elbows up.
Peel your body off the floor as you take a deep breath in.
And then slowly coming back down as you exhale.
Inhale, coming up.
Exhale, coming down. You work with your own range.
Still available movement in the shoulders at the highest point.
And then slowly coming down.
Return your hands next to the ribs. Take an in-breath here.
On an exhale, bring your butt back, your toes together. Active child's pose.
Can you pull the armpits away from one another and down to the floor? Can you keep your elbows off the floor, fingers spread, your hips heavy onto the heels? Take one extra breath here. And when you're ready, return your hands, place them next to your knees. We're going to keep our head where it is, just come on the crown of the head. You may walk your feet closer together. Mind that you can see your elbows and they're staggered over your wrists. Now pull a little bit.
The chin to the chest.
Pushing the hands, you see that my hand palms lift the floor. This is not necessary. You want to feel a little pull on the back of the neck. And then from there, gently release.
Hands back onto the hips.
Come on to the knees. Right foot steps forward. Arms come forward.
Inhale, arms go up. Tuck the left toes. Exhale, glide back. Place your left hand next to the right leg. Extend left leg. Inhale, come up into your twist. Place your left hand on the corner of the mat, outside of the left foot. Circle the arm. Press the right arm behind the left knee and lift the hips.
Take a deep breath in.
On an exhale, sit down. Right foot comes to the outside of the left knee, elbow to the right knee, and then flex the left toes. Take an inhale to lengthen, an exhale to twist. An inhale to lengthen, an exhale to twist.
Uncoil as you
inhale.
Replace your right foot on the inside of the left leg. Make your way through this shape on an in-breath. Bringing your right foot up and all the way to the left hand again. From here, I'd like to turn even more to the left. Bring the feet parallel and then fold forward until you can get your fingers, your hand, your head, your forearms on the floor. If you're very flexible, narrow your stance. If you need more space, widen your stance. Shift forward and back so that you can feel the stretch increasing from the back line to the inner thighs, posterior medial line of the legs. Come to center, lift your chest. You're gonna turn over to the left leg.
You're in a runner's lunge.
Inhale, let's move back. Downward facing dog as we exhale. Coming forward into plank, lifting the heels, bringing the shoulders over the wrist. Keep your upper back rounded, left knee taps down, and then extends again. Right knee taps down, and extends again. Both knees step down, untuck the toes, child's pose.
Active in the arms,
collarbones, breathing in and out. turn your hands next to the knees. Replace the crown of the head on the floor. And again, pull the back of the neck by pulling the chin in. Slowly backing off. For those that want, can lift up onto their head hair. This is obviously an option that you can take or leave. Wherever you're coming from, you're gonna slowly release.
Lean forward,
tuck the toes under. Come up, bring the hands onto the hips, even the lower back.
Step your left foot forward, release the hands, inhale. Exhale, gliding back. And you can again involve the back toes. So as you come forward, toenails on the floor. And as you come back, toes are tucked.
One more.
Circles up into your twist. Gaze up or down. You can again circle through the wrist if you'd like. It's not mandatory. Whatever feels right. Right hand goes to the right corner of the mat. Come on the outside of the right foot. Left foot sweeps or steps behind the right knee. Coming up. Expand the chest. Soften the neck. Take a deep breath in. And then slowly sit down. Flex the right toes.
Bring the left ankle past the right knee, hug your left knee in, and then lengthen the spine for the in-breath, twisting deeper for the out-breath. You're gonna stay one extra breath. Uncoiling on the in-breath. Replace your left foot, right hand coming up. Inhale, pick up your left foot. You can help with your left hand. It's gonna come all the way towards the direction of the right hand. Turning again with all 10 toes to the long side of the mat. Option to stay here. Whoever can go a little deeper can go a little deeper. You take the stretch that is most effective for your inner thighs, medial line of the leg. Wherever you're coming from, deepen the breath and make sure that we can meet with our legs wide again. Lifting the chest as you inhale. Turn over towards the right side as you exhale. Hands under the shoulders, deep breath in. Down dog. Exhalation. We're going to elevate the heels again. Inhale. Lower them down as you exhale. Next time, moving forward. Heels lift, ripple forward. Inhale. Through Chaturanga, all the way onto the belly as you exhale.
Widen your feet. Lift the feet off the floor. Lift your chest. And then sprinkle your fingers back. You may stay here if it feels right. You may grab your feet if it feels better. If you do grab the feet, the weight stays in the same part as with your feet in the air, which is the front of the hip bones and the pubic bone. If you're breathing here, you may rock a little from side to side. That's fine. Inhale. Exhale slowly. Release.
Bring your hands next to the ribs. Take another little cobra or up dog as you inhale.
We're going to meet on the knees again as we exhale.
Open your arms on
a deep breath in. Cross your right arm on top of the left. Give yourself a good hug, squeezing your shoulder blades into the hands.
Now from here, inhale.
Elbows in the direction of your belly, round.
Inhale up.
Exhale around. Next inhale, we're coming up with the spine, opening the arms. Change the arms, left arm on top, grabbing your shoulder blades. Twice. Inhale, elbows up. Exhale, slowly drawing in. Inhale, elbows up. Exhale, slowly.
Inhale,
open up, interlace the fingers behind the back, release the index fingers and pull the arms back as the chest rises. The gaze can go to where the wall meets the ceiling or up to the clouds. Deep breath in.
Fold forward as you exhale. Forehead, if possible,
nose touching down, pulling the fingers back. Relax your jaw, take another in-breath, and then slowly release into child's pose, more passive.
If you need to scooch a little bit more to one side, so you can roll from here onto your back. You might actually have to scooch yourself back onto the mat. But we're going to meet with the feet on the floor. Cool. Bring your hands next to the body. Right ankle onto the left knee. And then bring the left knee into the chest. You can thread the needle with your right hand, meaning you're going in between the legs and you're holding the left knee on top or behind. Now circle your free ankle, the left one, in the air. Hold for an extra breath. Bring your left foot down. Extend the right leg. Open the arms to the side and cross your left leg over towards the right side. If you want, you can hold the knee with the right hand. Chin to the left shoulder, three breaths in a twist. Untwist on an in-breath. Hands next to the body, feet on the floor. Bring your left ankle onto the right knee and draw your right knee in. Left arm goes through if it fits. Shoulders, hips on the floor. Circle the right ankle. Both directions. Pull a little stronger. And then slowly release. Right foot flex, left leg extends. Cross right leg over to the left. Open the arms to the side if you want. You can hold the knee with your left. Three breaths in your twist. Uncoil on the in-breath. Bring both knees into the chest. Lift your head, lift your shoulders, hug your legs with your arms. Make yourself tiny, little small like a ball. Option here to rest on your back. And take a resting position, Shavasana, or any variation. Option to start grabbing behind the knees and rolling yourself up to continue your practice. Let me know if you have any feedback for this. Have a wonderful day.